First one, you wanna be on video?
You wanna help me show the people how to make the overnight oats?
French toast?
Mmm, sounds good.
Today I'm gonna show you guys how to make a delicious overnight oats French toast style. This is gonna be perfect for the summertime because if you're anything like me, I don't like eating a hot meal first thing in the morning on a summer day. I want something cool, chilled, but also filling and satisfying. So overnight oats is that perfect recipe for you. All you're gonna do is take a mixing bowl. We're gonna take our mixing bowl and we're gonna start with our oats. And I got suckered into these Quaker rolled overnight oats. Are they essential? Probably not, but what they are is just a thicker rolled oat, so that's kind of perfect for soaking overnight. And I like my oats thick, all right? I'm gonna measure out a half a cup. You can do a full cup, you can do whatever the heck you wanna do. I'm gonna do a half cup. For the protein, this is the essence here, okay? This is what you have to have. There's no working around this. You guys need the plant-based protein and banana maple French toast. I live by this, swear by this, I will die by this protein. It's so delicious and great in so many recipes. I'm gonna do a full scoop of the plant protein, and this will provide for you alone in this is 20 grams of protein. In addition, you're gonna get a little bit of protein from the oats and other items that we add in here. One of my favorite ingredients to add to overnight oats are chia seeds. So if you guys don't have these, you can pick them up at any grocery store. There's no reason not to. Such a great addition to oats, smoothies, you name it. Add it in there, it makes your overnight oats that much thicker and also adds in great nutrition, heart healthy fats. You're gonna get protein and fiber from your chia seeds. So I'm gonna go ahead and add 1 tablespoon of chia seeds. Now to make it taste more French toast-like, we are gonna add in some Saigon cinnamon. And if you haven't tried the Saigon cinnamon, it's got a more cinnamony flavor to it, so I highly recommend that. And then we're also gonna add in some pure vanilla extract, just like you would if you were making French toast. Just like a teaspoon in there. And for sweetener, a couple options here. You could use pure maple syrup, which I've got hanging around in a gallon jug. And then I've also got here a more sugar-free, calorie-friendly option. It's the now better stevia in maple. So I'm gonna go ahead and add in a couple squirts of this. Believe it or not, a couple squirts of this go a long way in terms of sweetness. You don't need a lot, so I probably added more than I actually need in there. Then we're gonna add in milk. So I'm using the unsweetened almond milk. Some people use yogurt. You could do yogurt or milk, or you could do both. But to keep this more of a vegan-friendly, plant-based option, I'm just gonna do the almond milk. And we're gonna start with 1/4 cup, mix it around. We're probably gonna need more than that, but I like to start with a little bit less and stir it around. You'll find with the plant-based proteins, they're just so much thicker. They absorb a lot more liquid. So anytime you're doing smoothies or adding this to any of your recipes, you'll usually need a little bit more liquid than you normally would. It's definitely gonna get nice and thick overnight after it chills in the fridge, especially with the addition of the chia. If you want it a little bit more soupy, you could add in a little bit more milk, but I kinda like what we're working with here right now. So that's the consistency. And all we're gonna do is I've got this cute little mason jar, kind of perfect portion. We're gonna go ahead and add this to the mason jar, that way it can chill overnight. And before we finish this up, you guys can add any additional toppings that you want here. I'm gonna add just one more sprinkle of Saigon cinnamon. And then to give it that extra French toast flavor, I'm gonna add some sliced up banana to it. You guys could add nuts, chocolate chips, sprinkles, add whatever the heck you want on there. I'm gonna go ahead and put this in the fridge, chill it overnight, and then tomorrow morning I'm gonna have a perfect, super filling breakfast. You can heat this up if you want it warm. I personally eat it chilled. It's delicious, it's so thick and creamy, and it's gonna taste just like French toast.